even following these sexual stereotypes, we can still be healthy. Because we practice yoga. Cool. Why 90% of women don't have an orgasm during sex? And can Tantra make a difference? Вита Филиппова asked. Сергей, according to statistics, 90% of women don't have an orgasm during sex, but just imitate it for one reason or another. This is the information of sexologists. Can Tantra make a difference? Vita, thanks for the question. I will even record the answer on camera because this question is very, very important. Why does this happen? My deep conviction is that for relationships between people, if they are sincere, they are mutual. And at any level, at the level of Ajna Chakra, Vishuddha, or Svadhisthana, this is if there is attraction, sincere attraction, not manipulative when a person is trying to achieve some goal, but sincere, then his chosen one will also feel this attraction. But we have so many games that we play in relationships, and we think these games are sincere attraction. And not having an orgasm is connected with exactly this, because you cannot lie to your body. The mind can play any game, and it can justify everything. It will explain that right is left, that top is the bottom, that good and evil are mixed and so on, but the body will always say how it really is. Therefore, if a woman doesn't get an orgasm, it means that there is insincerity. But in this webinar, there was already a question about the widespread biased attitude towards sexuality in society. This affects the statistics that 90% of women do not experience orgasm. Men do experience orgasm. Why? Because they need to live up to this accepted idea that a man must finish. If you haven't finished, then this is something very strange. But that is violence against the body. As a result, men have prostatitis and other issues. That is all of this, the result of, we can call it social games. But you could also say that we are shifting responsibility, because if you don't shift the responsibility and honestly look at this fact that there are 90% of women who do not have an orgasm, look in the mirror and say, that's me, I really do, yes, that's me, what I can change, do I want to live like this further, or do I want to change something, and start changing. The mind will turn on, it will seek some kind of rationalization. Well, yes, but everyone lives like that, it's normal, there is no other way. Let the mind work, let it play its game, but you will act. You see, we do yoga, we do stretching. This affects us a lot. Even following these sexual stereotypes, we can still be healthy, because we practice yoga. Cool. Even if you are not self-realized through Manipura chakra, but you practice yoga, you may not have, for example, gastritis or ulcers, because every day you do Uddiyana Bandha, 1,000 times Uddiyana Bandha Kriya, every day, and everything is great with you, but this doesn't mean that you live harmoniously. That is, you will need to look deeper. Yoga helps us a lot. But if you also turn on consciousness and at the same time carry out yoga practices, then really you can free yourself. Then you will really make love for love and have sex with pleasure. It's funny to talk about it to adults. It's funny because our sexual organs funny. Even small children know this. And I remember myself in childhood when I still was lying wrapped up by my mom and I felt sexual pleasure. Do you understand? I don't know what age it was, but I remember that my mother had wrapped me up and I felt pleasure. And then this feeling began to overlap with social norms, some games that schoolmates play, and all this began to overlap. And it turns out that speaking of sex, we return to some childhood, there is regression. And it seems to the mind that it says, well, you are degrading, it's not so beautiful, let's look up, let's look at Ajna Chakra, at Vishuddha, let's think about them, why should we think about sexuality? But you need to understand that this is a game. Go back to the mirror, look at yourself and ask again, does everything suit me in this aspect or not? If not, it means it's a game. You need to notice this game and end it. Take action. And it will be very difficult to act. Here is the most interesting thing. When you begin to act, you will understand that Tantra is really the way of warrior. It's really difficult. Your legs don't want to move. You don't know what to say to give a person a compliment. But not just, oh, what a nice scarf you have, but to say it in flirty and sexual way, especially to a person who you are attracted to, it's just a nightmare. We immediately can see and understand what we need to work on. Here it is. You don't need to go anywhere to find it or come up with it yourself. You don't need to sit in contemplation to develop the body of light in yourself. No, just do it. When you do something, life changes. Right away. Bah! Right away. Easy. But you need to do something. Therefore, act. And thanks for the question. Completely. I'm a dragon. And suddenly my mind turned on. I think, wait a minute. But how do dragons make love? My lover has a tail. But I need to find her legs somehow. But I was in such a deep trance state that I didn't leave this state. It often happens that when our mind turns on, we fly out of meditation. We are just surprised. What is it? How it can be? No way! And that's it. Our meditation ends, but Tantra continued for me. And two dragons made love.